In today's video, I'm taking you thrifting with me to two Goodwills in the Twin Cities metro area of Minnesota. Here we go. This first Goodwill was located in West St. Paul. It's one I hadn't really been to before, I don't think. I wasn't sure what to make of their prices. Some of the prices on these teacup sets were kind of high at $6.99, but then they had mugs for $1.49. So it was kind of a mixed bag of prices at this location. When I go thrifting, I'm often looking for items to add to my own collections or to use in my home decor. But I also have a little booth at a vintage shop in a town nearby. It's called The Pink Elephant in Hopkins, Minnesota. And sometimes I will look for items to add to my resale booth. I was excited to see these sets on the shelf. This is the Pfalzgraf folk art pattern, and I don't use these for my everyday dishes, but I do have a few select pieces as a collection, and I don't have any teacups and saucers. So I did bring one of the sets home for $1.49, and this will be joining the other pieces in my collection, which are currently put away for my Valentine's decor. But I'll be bringing those back out when I bring out my spring decor. I do collect these little angels, but I already have this one. It's the November angel. And at $3.99, I didn't really want to pick it up for resale. It's kind of a high price for resale. I was contemplating this blue willow platter. This is a pattern that I like to collect. And I was really thinking about it. I thought it was a very good price at $3.99, but as I was looking at it, I noticed there was a flaw in the glaze. And I was like, you know what? The reason I would get a piece that's newer is so that I could actually use it, but then I wouldn't want to use a piece that has a flaw in the glaze. So then I'd rather just have an old one with lots of crazing that's just for show. So in the end, I wound up not getting it. Upon further review, I really should have picked up this Pyrex for resale. It was $4.99. The lids alone can go for a lot more than that, so that would have been a good pickup for my booth, but I didn't think of it at the time. This adorable junior sifter was a great find for $3.99. I looked it up online and they sell for like $15 to $20. I'm not selling it. I actually did pick this up for my own self for my collection at home. And so I'm displaying it here in my kitchen. My goal is to have like a peg rack at some point in my kitchen that I can hang things like this from. But for now, I'm happy to just have it here in my kitchen. As a collector of thermoses, I can tell you $10.99 for this thermos without its lid is a really high price, higher than I would even charge if I had it in my vintage booth. So I don't know what they were thinking with that price. This old magazine holder caught my eye. I thought it was really pretty with the little floral detail there on the front. I like this tone of wood, this darker tone, and it was only $4.99. So I actually did bring this home. I'm not sure if I'm going to use it at the Pink Elephant for displaying things I'm selling or if I'm just going to keep it in my own house because it looks really good with the rest of my stuff. So we'll see, but I did pick it up. I thought it was a great buy for $4.99. I pick up older globes when I find them because Gabriel likes them and we put them in his room, but this one was $14.99, which I thought was a little bit high. This next Goodwill is located in Hopkins, Minnesota, and their prices are usually mixed. I did find some nice prices on things. I haven't found a pheasant in a while to add to my little collection. I put them out during fall for my fall decor, and so I was happy to find this little guy. I did bring him home. He is a salt shaker, but several of my little pheasants are just lonely salt shakers. The music at our Goodwills is really loud, so I couldn't put what Chris was saying about this book, but he was really happy to find this book because it's written by a guy that he really likes. You might have seen in a video a few videos back that we expanded our space in the shop where we sell things to give Chris a little more room for like figures and comic books. And so we got this Ninja Turtle bank. They sell on eBay for about $20 to $30, depending on the condition and the character. So we got this. We thought it would also look fun in the booth. So I did bring that home for $3.99. I really don't need another tray in my life, and thrift flips don't really sell in my little vintage booth. So I did leave this behind, but I thought it was pretty clever. It looks like someone turned a cabinet door into a decorative tray and added some hardware. I really liked it. Francoma is a pretty well-known potter, but I have never seen a Francoma piece in a white glaze, so I thought that was kind of cool. I didn't love the shape of it. It was kind of too, I don't know, floofy for me. I like more streamlined shapes on my pictures, but I did think it was cool to see a white Francoma. I don't do a lot with selling a lot of Tupperware, but a lot of people come into the shop looking for it, and this was only $1.99, so I thought I would give it a try in my booth. I thought this turtle was pretty cute. I don't know if he's a soap dish or just like a trinket dish, but either way, I did pick it up to put at the Pink Elephant. I know this will sell to the youths. I really like copper pieces with like brass accents, and I have a few in my kitchen already. So I bought this to go underneath a candle that I have sitting on my tiered tray. It adds a nice little layer to my tiered tray while also protecting the tray from candle wax. I really liked this teapot. I actually had it in my cart for a little bit. $6.99 is a little high for me, but I would spend it, but I was like, you know what? I don't feel like spending it. I don't love it enough. So I did leave that. I don't do a lot with clear glass and crystal, but I thought this was really different. It was egg-shaped. I thought it would be really pretty with jelly beans for Easter time, but I'm gonna hold out till I find it cheaper. And that's all that I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed thrifting with me at these two Goodwills in the Twin Cities metro area of Minnesota. And thank you so much for watching and checking out what I bought. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.